Ray! Get out!
What is that?
Out!
Sorry! Sir?
You should be apologizing to me.
I'm sorry, nature can be cruel.
But you don't close the door.
Well, it's because I have nothing to hide.
Trust me, you do. All right, Ray, take them over to your mother's and she can babysit all of you.
Frank, the kids are here. Buckle your pants.
Raymond, dear, a marriage is about being together, about closeness.
It is about closeness. About how much closeness you can take. About how close you can get to killing her before you kill yourself.
Around the block in 37 minutes.
He beat your record, Marie.
What am I rushing back to?
Deborah has a mustache. I hate Ray.
I can see that. But I don't want to lie to you. A couple minutes with the mouthwash would be time well spent.
It's not spying if you love the person.
That's what peeping Toms say.
We both know that I'm lazy, I don't help out with the kids, and until recently my breath has been questionable.
It's cathartic.
All right, we have to get a dictionary for in here. So, all of a sudden you're this old blues-singing guy with a mustache. Okay, so you cry because I'm stupid.
I eat ice cream because you're stupid.
I'm glad you're here. It's better. Not so much meh, 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 meh. What? Meh, 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 meh. Oh, I get it, yeah.
Bap, 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 bap.
Giorgio, che cosa stai facendo? Hai versato tutto sulla tavola, ma sei un porco!
Sì, cara, scusami.
We're all getting in that.
Good luck, sweetie.
Well, look at it. There's Allie and the twins, and there's you and me, and look at your parents.
Oh, she made them giants.
Yeah.
With sharp teeth and claws.
Yeah, and they're attacking our house.
Stop! The easiest money ever made.
Easier than the 40 bucks you got when you couldn't do 7 push-ups?
It was 10, Andy. I couldn't do 10 push-ups.
It doesn't matter because you stopped after 2.
Oh, the day you were born was the happiest day of our lives.
No, that's true. It was.
And you know they've been lying to us our whole lives? Anytime they ever try to make us feel good about ourselves.
When did that happen to me?
Oh, honey, I'm sure we lied to you plenty of times.
Other parents aren't lying, Ma. They believe in their children.
No, they don't. It was even worse than last time.
You made me hate TV.
A mother's concerned because Peter is an on-camp layabout who constantly disappoints us, that's all.
Well, maybe he just needs a little advice. You know, man to man.
That is a great idea. Ray, maybe you could go over and, talk to him.
Maybe when you're done with Peter, you can heal a leper.
But I forced myself, just like you did, to the mean lady in the bar. Only in this case, I got to marry the mean lady. We got us a little shindig here.
Ah! Oh, really?
Well, I'm sure Carol's into science fiction, too. She wears glasses.
Really, the pleasure is all mine.
What if they start dating? Huh? We already have enough horrible people in this family.
is not to go out with a she-beast who once tried to beat me up.
Ray, I was there. She did beat you up. Look, I'm sorry, but this party is kind of just for people who are looking for a spouse.
I'm in.
Deborah, is this what you're serving? Oh, don't worry. I'll save your party.
Hey, Peter, you're all cleaned up. What did you do, join a cult? What's your problem, stupid?
Marie, you just stay in there and fix my bad cooking.
Okay. Which is my Stefania. I mean, she's my ex, Stefania. You're my Stefania now.
I think it's hilarious that you beat Ray up. Because you're a girl.
Listen, it wasn't easy. And Ray is quite a girl himself.
No, no.
Listen, are you finished sticking your nose into our conversation, or does that thing just get stuck in every conversation? I'm just going to go.
Okay. You see, Deborah, this is what happens when you let people get hungry.
Oh, I get it now. This is not about me. You want another soldier in the fight against your enemy.
Who's that?
Wait, don't go yet. Please, Peggy, I'm not like these people. They're freaks.
She's right, not her. She's not family.
That's how I'm able to go on.
What's to eat here?
Probably nothing. I'll make you something.
It's true. You don't have to talk. We should go to movies more.
Movies, something, yeah.
Want me to go?
If you don't sit in front of me.
One of these days you'll turn around and I won't be here.
Not today.
They want to talk to my supervisor.
You should know I'm interviewing other people for your position.
Where'd you get that shirt? Big, tall, and Samoan?
Oh, there's a new Robert in town.
Yeah, well, he still has that old Robert smell.
Why don't you add a grass skirt to that outfit and dance around a volcano?
It's not a cult. It's just a bunch of people who want to see me happy, who happen to care about me.
You have that here, you stupid ass!
Something. Robert is so impressionable.
Yeah, he's a dope. So what do we do? Huh? What if they drug me and I wake up chained to a goat?
You just described my wedding.
And that family, that love is stronger than any crazy-faced loser collection of pinheads. Where's Frank?
What did they do to him? Why is he smiling like that?
No underpants.
Well, what's the party for? The Dalai Lama over here?
Okay.
Because they're nice boys, and you're a gloating nincompoop.
Well, I'll tell you what the problem is, Deborah.
I was hoping you would, Marie.
You let the kids play all those computer videotronic games, and after that, school is just boring to them. It's just an old lady talking.
Where do you get those videotronic games?
Why do I say anything?
Exactly.
How about you just say Robert the stink-footed oaf?
You know, I had a lot of things to do today, and I couldn't because I had to stay here with Michael.
There's always time to get your hair done, dear.
I wasn't going to do my hair.
Oh. We should talk about that, too.
Sorry, Ray, I gotta go.
No, 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 you come back here, young lady. Old lady! Who reminds me of my mom?
You called the teacher mommy? Why? Was the teacher yelling?
Let's just say our kids are lucky that their father has led a very embarrassing life.
Hey, look!
That's what you wanted, wasn't it? A day without the kids so you can catch up on the cleaning? Well, maybe we should do it more often.
No, no, no. When everybody goes, then this becomes the happy zone. You're a hostile driver.
He's a hostile person. You should see him brush his teeth.
I am not driving with you until you get that renewed.
That's incentive? Why couldn't my marriage license expire? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey, hey. I'll walk.
Oh, honey, look, it's almost 103.
No, just... 103.
Yeah.
It's a scale. That's what your head weighs.
Oh, God, look at you, Deborah. Ugh. Feeling better, honey?
Yeah, you know, I think that garlic actually helped. To tell you the truth, I thought that was an old wives' tale.
Look who you're talking to.
Oh, I don't think she's a floozy, Marie.
Then why date her?
Oh. Sounds to me like maybe you're not so okay with it.
Oh, you're picking up on that, Einstein?
I wish I was Einstein, because then I'd invent a time machine and go back to when you were nice.
Hey, what if those two get married? Oh, and have a kid.
Maybe a brother this time, huh? You can burp and change your own brother-in-law.
Everybody, I want you to meet Emma.
Hello.
No brother for Deborah.
Come, we've been expecting you.
Well, not you exactly.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Emma. And that's a lovely pantsuit.
Oh, this old thing.
Happy New Year!
Yeah, it's good, because you know, we all thought Warren was going to go for someone younger, but it turns out he's just going for someone different.
Kill is going to Deborah you.
It's not all about looks and sex for me.
Okay, but is any of it?
I'm trying to picture myself with a woman who's older. She'd have to be like a mummy or something.
You'd love to have someone different, wouldn't you?
That's a secret?
I'd see you sitting on that couch, sneaking peeks at her while she backed in with the same look you have for your Sports Illustrated swimsuit issue. You make me sick!
I'm a little sick, too.
Wait a minute! I don't know what the hell you're talking about! Okay, maybe I would look at the swimsuit issue, but that doesn't mean I'm going to leave you for one of those girls.
And the only reason you don't is that they don't ask you.
Thank you, Ma!
You still need reassurance after 45 years of bondage?
Come on, you want to say something bad about my wife, you can. I don't care. Come on. Say it. She's a bad cook and she's mean. Hey.
And guys just want to relax and watch TV, and I should have left you alone.
Amy, will you marry me?
Let me get this straight. Raymond insults you, but you get mad at me, and then you apologize to him? What, are you taking lessons from my mom?
You know, when I need to talk to Ray about, like, my feelings or our children, I know I have until the commercial's over. That gives me 30 seconds. And if there's a girl in the commercial or a truck with big wheels or, God forbid, a monkey, forget it.
Hello, Raymond.
Hello, Mother. Oh, look, Mom, a bear in pants.
Yes, your brother is quite hairy.
No, Ma, he's not doing it right.
Yes, he is. But he's also ugly. He should really wear a welder's mask.
Why don't I weld your mouth to your ass and make a donut out of you?
And now I realize that maybe it's not my fault. Maybe it's just that you're boring. I was just trying to hurt your feelings.
Good job.
I want to be close to everyone in this family.
Why?
Did you tell him about my pedicures?
No, Robert.
Robert paints his feet like a lady.
All right, Deborah. I brought you some baking soda for your fridge. I smelled something questionable.
No, isn't Molly's mom that Peggy, the scoutmaster Nazi cookie Hitler?
Yeah, that's how she's listed in the phone book. I'm sure she won't beat you up this time.
I don't know, Allie.
See, that's right. If I can't figure it out, then Allie's dad certainly will. Ex-husband.
Ex. Hmm. Surprise, surprise. All right.
Robert, do you want a glass of wine first?
One more time.
Well, now I'm a little nauseous.
Oh, because I am so attracted to you, Captain Flatpants.
My God!
Oh, Mom!
Oh, my God!
Mom! 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 Sorry. She's a little sick, too.
Dear, I told you, dear, you have to keep up with your housekeeping.
Marie, why don't
you... Oh, children, don't come on. Off the floor right now. Come on, you're all coming to stay with Grandma.
No. We have a hotel that we're going to stay at while they tent the house.
A hotel? Those places are even dirtier than here.
Come on, a guy gets in bed with you, you put some pants on.
I will not. You don't want to sleep with me? Go back to your wife.
I'm not going to be able to sleep ever. You are a little too free with the body.
You see, dear, when we help you, we're actually helping.
Why don't you go complete the outfit and put on the toilet seat cover?
Man, are they annoying.
Yeah, at least you get to go home.
Because it's the last time it'll be the face of a man who's never been to the greatest place a man could go.
Wherever it is, I hope they have mouthwash.
Smell him.
Come here. Come here. Oh, my God!
Somebody better be dead or dying.
Smack him, Frank. Ow!
Can I go back to bed now?
Do you know what he's been doing? Smell him. Girl, not dead. His shirt. Okay.
All right.
Well, Mr. Barone, I'll ask you the same thing. Why don't you just drink poison?
Do you have any?
Don't you know that smoking can stunt your growth?
Hey, Puff the Magic Dragon. It probably looks like Frankenstein blew a fuse. Oh, you're not a smoker? I had so many more names for you. Smoking a Bear, HR Puffin' Stuff, Towering Inferno. That's the one who smokes. Great, I've become you.
Now you know I love you with all my heart, Hank. But I think if I didn't have my cigarettes, I would have to fight you.
You know, like Ray. He has to drive around the block a few times every night listening to the radio before he goes home to face Deborah.
All right, save it, Ray. You don't think I've seen you circling the block all hunched over, just a big nose and a steering wheel going around?
That's right. Do you think you're easy to live with all the time, Pat? So skittish and faint-hearted and, oh, my. You're on the couch recuperating from your trip to the grocery store. You know, if that cake really is lousy, we could just blow it up.
Do I disgust you? I disgust you,
no,
don't I?
No, no, no. Not all the time.
And now Frank and I get along so much better.
Yeah, Deborah and I have always dreamed of having a marriage like yours.
So, what do you think?
Oh, it's incredible. Yeah, what do you got coming out of the tap now? Holy water?
The bathroom belongs to the king.
Yes, and it appears Raymond has abdicated his throne.
Look, all I know is when I said I would get out of there, she's been all happy, and that's good enough for me.
Why don't you move out completely? You'll get action all the time.
A person goes, achoo! Not, nyee!
Oh. So I should just let it go and spray everything like you. You sneeze like it's a big Broadway musical finale. Achoo! 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 Good night, everybody! Enjoy my mucus!
You gotta control everything. Especially in here.
Up your nose?
And into my brain.
Well, I guess I would use the biggest opening. Because maybe I don't want to think that my husband, who I'm married to, would like to live with a monkey.
Well, maybe I would.
Well, maybe I do.
Hey.
Oh, crap.
Thanks. You might want to cinch that robe. You got a little fruit coming out of the loom.
Yeah. Yeah, then I can take a shower at least.
I was gonna say.
You've upset your mother. She came to me looking for comfort. I'm not set up for that.
Like, how about when you joke about how you wish a tidal wave would come and sweep Mom out to sea?
I have never been more serious about anything in my entire life.
Look at him. No wife, no children. Pathetic.
Look, this is marriage. You wake up in the morning and she's there. You come home at night and she's there. You eat, she's there. You go to sleep, there. And I know that sounds like a bad thing. But it's not.
I would like a minute for rebuttal.
Okay, bad example.
But you and Amy were doing fine until he screwed things up.
See? Always there. I guess I should have done more.
More than nothing, Ray?
She said she was joking and I should have saved her life.
Well, you know, Raymond, I've always found Deborah to be very demanding. But you just don't want sensitive. I mean, sensitive doesn't scare off a burglar or a peeping Tom.
That's a big problem around here, is it?
You're sweet, but you're also manly. You're a strapping, virile man.
Said his mommy.
And you don't have a big nose, dear. It's perfect for your face.
It's perfect for two faces.
I get the job done.
Oh, we're getting some conflicting reports. Apparently, you're weaker than a feeble old geezer, and you almost lost your bride to an orange.
Come on, Ray. Our bodies are covered with hair for a reason.
To nauseate your fellow diners?
I'm serious. My legs are taller than you.
Andy, at the end of the day, you have to blow up your lady.
Thank you, Andy, but you're really not helping me with the me-to-you comparison, okay?
For now.
Aha! Very funny, Cousin Ed. Never happens to like the fact that I have just the right amount of hair in just the right amount of places.
Oh, I'm sure that was a comforting last thought before she blacked out. Raymond's body's so smooth, like a hairless cat.
Where's my pot roast?
Oh, well, that's over at my house.
What? What's it doing over there?
Well, when I smelled it earlier, it definitely needed some work.
They're not going to be over every day.
Oh, you poor, blind, fat lady.
But I brought you some ziti for your company. You can tell them that you made it.
Where do you want them, Ma?
Yeah, right in there, sweetie. All right. Move things around. Yeah. Good. Oh, these potatoes are no good.
What do you mean? We love these potatoes. Look at this. It's a potato for them.
No. Don't give him that. I'll make him some good potatoes.
Why can't I hit a ball like that?
I could answer that, or you could just look in the mirror.
Look, I know a lot of stuff's going on femininely. I know it's not your fault. I understand that. It's like a Jekyll and Hyde thing. Only more Hyde. Probably need a prescription for bitches. What are you talking about? Look, I'm just trying to help.
You should be quiet.
Yes. Sometimes I just want to smack you.
It's just that it sounds like you're becoming just like your father.
This is not huggable. This is not Deborah. This is the woman who shows up once a month to rip into me like a monkey on a cupcake.
The third prize.
You're out of the troop.
But I appreciate all the organization she does. She's a great troop leader.
Yeah, so was Hitler. This is nice.
Hey.
Was nice.
Claggy! Wait a minute, look, what's wrong with my teeth?
Have you ever looked in your mouth? It's like a prison riot.
How many times have I offered to take her to my beauty salon?
So she can have this look?
Oh, you have an arch enemy. What, are you a superhero now?
Captain Big Nose.
I'm gonna blow you away.
You don't like women.
Who likes women?
What? You're my mother. You're not a woman.
Dr. Freud on line one for you, Raymond.
He didn't want to talk.
To you. He didn't want to talk to you.
Exactly.
I have no problem with women.
You have no women.
And there's one thing you need to understand.
What's that? ABC? Always be cranky?
You should have seen the looks on their faces, especially the giant and the bald one.
Well, I just want to help because I'm sensing a lull.
There's no lull.
Listen. Lull.
Well, don't worry, because I'm going to do my toast.
Oh. Well, maybe there might be a lull after that.
Amy? Welcome to the family. Lots of luck.
No matter what you've done, no matter how much shame you brought upon us.
Got a nap in the car, so.
I don't understand. Why were they arrested for that?
Were you naked?
Drunken driving! Oh, my God! Drunken driving! Oh, it is so awful! Now it all makes sense. The messy house, the kids running around filthy, the way she talks to me. What, it's all clear now.
If I spend one more day in the car with your mother, it's going to be in the garage with the door closed.
She should have lawyered up.
You didn't brush your teeth today, did you?
I should be drunk every day. But I'm not, because I do not have a drinking problem, sir. What I have is a mother-in-law problem.
I should have just stepped aside and let you serve your frozen whatevers.
Goodbye, everybody, and good luck to whoever's marrying into this.
You know, the moose is actually a very vicious animal.
You and a moose would be a good fight.
We'll see you later. Okay, Marie?
But I think I missed something. If anybody needs to talk to me, I'm just right across the street.
I was looking for Marie.
Oh, yeah? For me, just the opposite.
I keep a lot of stuff inside, too.
No, you don't. I drop a sock on the floor, you scream like a horror movie.
There's plenty more I keep inside, believe me.
There can't be a lot left in there.
Their marriage was like a rock. The one solid rock for me.
No. Maybe it was more like a stone, right? And now it has passed. Deborah's parents. Why don't you see if you got a coupon in there for shock treatments?
I know you've never been crazy about them, but can't you at least pretend?
I am pretending. I have too many parents. Could you take one of them, please?
Narrow-minded, intrusive, completely insensitive, oblivious, and cheap.
Okay, now let's do my mother. Well, I'm sorry, we have parents.
You know what really worried me tonight, Ray, is you started to remind me of your parents.
Oh, hey, there's no need to name call.
Do you realize in a group that includes your father, you're being the most insensitive?
Sammy. The animal rights people sent Robert a thank you for the humane way that he stopped the bull.
Here's my favorite. Runaway bull. Cop gets horny.
This is kind of like Christmas morning. If I was really bad.